So, welcome back, my dear students. In the previous video, we have discussed about four equivalent conditions for convergence. So, we have understood more about convergence. In lighter terms, a sequence xn converges to x means if you take a neighborhood of x, which is x minus epsilon, x plus epsilon interval, xn should belong to this interval after a certain stage, which means that xn plus 1, xn plus 2, xn plus 3, xn plus 4, etc. All the terms should belong to this interval. Okay, please keep in mind that this k depends upon epsilon. So if you take a smaller interval, I take x minus epsilon 1, okay, then k should be bigger. Here if we denote it by k1, then n greater than or equal to k2, this k2 should be bigger than k1. This is the basic idea. So except for finitely many terms, in this case, except for x1, x2, etc., xk1 minus 1, except for this many terms, all other terms belongs to this interval. That's what I have explained it. Except for finitely many terms, all the terms of the sequence belongs to some neighborhood of x. This is what actually convergence means. Finite terms ഒഴികെ, finitely many terms ഒഴികെ, ബാക്കി എല്ലാ ടേംസും ഒരു പോയിന്റിന്റെ ചെറിയ നെയ്ബർഹുഡിൽ ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ആ സീക്വൻസിനെ കൺവേർജൻസ് എന്ന് പറയാം. വീണ്ടും വീണ്ടും പറയുന്നതിന്റെ ഉദ്ദേശം, യു ഷുഡ് ഹാവ് എ ബെറ്റർ ഐഡിയ അബൌട്ട് ദിസ് കൺവേർജൻസ് തിങ് ഓക്കെ. ഐ ഹോപ്പ് യു അണ്ടർസ്റ്റുഡ്. ദെൻ വിൽ മൂവ് ഓൺ ടു എക്സാമ്പിൾസ്. ഓക്കെ, ലെറ്റ്സ് ഡിസ്കസ് അബൌട്ട് ഫസ്റ്റ് എക്സാമ്പിൾ. സോ വി ഹാവ് ടു പ്രൂവ് ദാറ്റ് എക്സ് എൻ ഈസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു 1/n. We have to prove that this sequence converges to 0, or this is denoted as limit 1 by n should be equal to 0 എന്ന് നമുക്ക് പ്രൂവ് ചെയ്യാം. എങ്ങനെയാണ് ഇത് പ്രൂവ് ചെയ്യുന്നതെന്നാണ് നമ്മൾ നോക്കുന്നത്. ഓക്കെ, x എന്നൊരു സീക്വൻസ് തന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്, ആ സീക്വൻസ് സീറോയിലേക്ക് കൺവേർജ് ചെയ്യുന്നതാണ് നമുക്ക് പ്രൂവ് ചെയ്യാം. സോ ദ ബേസിക് ഐഡിയ ഈസ് വി യൂസ് ദ ഡെഫിനിഷൻ. ഓക്കെ, ദ ഡെഫിനിഷൻ ഈസ് ദ ഓൺലി തിങ് വിച്ച് വി ഹാവ്. ഓക്കെ, so a sequence xn converges to x means, by our definition, modulus of xn minus x is less than epsilon for all n greater than or equal to k. This k depends upon epsilon. This is the basic idea. Okay, so in this case xn is 1 by n, x is 0. So we take that modulus of 1 by n minus 0, this is xn and this is x. Modulus of xn minus x is less than epsilon, which means that modulus of 1 by n is less than epsilon. Since modulus of 1 by n or 1 by n is positive, instead of modulus of 1 by n, we can substitute 1 by n as well. So 1 by n is less than epsilon. So this is trivially true, since by Archimedean property, Archimedean property, we have a result that for every epsilon greater than 0, there exists a natural number n such that, or k such that, 1 by k is less than epsilon. If 1 by k is less than epsilon, 1 by k plus 1, which is less than 1 by k, should be always less than epsilon. Similarly, 1 by k plus 2, which is less than 1 by k plus 1, should be less than epsilon. And 1 by k plus 3, which is less than 1 by k plus 2, which is less than 1 by k plus 1, which is less than 1 by k is less than epsilon. We can proceed like this. So after the number k, we can say that 1 by n is less than epsilon. This is true by the Archimedean property. So for a given epsilon, I can always find a k such that 1 by k is less than epsilon. Okay. From that, we can say that for all n greater than or equal to k, 1 by n is less than epsilon. Okay, this is true because Archimedean property, if we find a particular natural number k such that 1 by k is less than epsilon, we can always find such a number because of the Archimedean property. If we take a natural number after that state, that is k plus 1, k plus 2, k plus 3, k plus 4, etc., the reciprocal of that number should always be less than 1 by k. Since 1 by k is less than epsilon, I can safely say that after the kth stage, the reciprocal of every number is less than epsilon. That's why I say that if we take n which is greater than or equal to k, 1 by n is less than epsilon for every n greater than or equal to k. So this means that our definition is valid. That is, 1 by n is less than epsilon for every n greater than or equal to k. This k is obtained from epsilon by the Archimedean property. So 1 by n is less than epsilon after a certain stage, which means that the sequence xn, that is 1 by n, is converging to 0. 1 by n minus 0 is less than epsilon after a certain stage means that the sequence 1 by n converging to 0. So we have established that the sequence 1 by n converging to 0 is true. I hope you understood. Thank you.